This video is part of a series of videos focusing on the character relationship moments on screen between Yaz and the 13th Doctor. If you'd like to start at the beginning, click the link in the corner. Otherwise, welcome to the next video. So far in season 11, Yaz and the companions have had DNA bombs implanted in their collarbones. They've had universal translators implanted in the napes of their necks. And now in episode 5, they have their bodies disrupted by a sonic mine. This episode focuses more on Ryan's backstory, paralleling the relationship between him and his father with that of Yoss becoming a father to a son when he is too young and not ready. It also shows us what the 13th Doctor is like early into her regeneration while dealing with crisis. We'll see a more mature 13 during the crises throughout Flux, but to be fair, she was dealing with that series of events without also having to have her internal organs disrupted and in mid-healing. The Doctor and Yaz do get a couple moments together on screen. At the antimatter drive, Yaz snaps at the Doctor.
Yaz, you have to keep this safe from the Pating. If this drive gets destroyed, the ship will lose propulsion, will drift endlessly while the Pating...
I get it. It won't be good.
It's not clear why Yaz is reacting this way, but my guess is that she's saying, we've been traveling together for a while now. You know me well enough, but you're talking down to me right now, over-explaining as you would to someone you just met. I'm smart and capable, and I can handle more. Or Yaz could be having her own way of internalizing the physical disruption from the sonic mine, and this is her not being able to hold it in any longer. Either way, it's a small precursor to the relationship quarrel that they have later on in the episode.
I'm really trusting you on this bomb, but I don't know what you're doing. Think of the Pating as a mouse, and the bomb as a piece of cheese. A very large piece of cheese about to explode and take us all with it. It's not a perfect analogy, I'll admit. You could have picked a bigger number. As the bomb gets closer, the energy's building, getting ready to blow. The Pating must be attracted to that. Surely, that's what I've been working on this whole time. Oh, please don't be wrong. I'll be so embarrassed and dead.
Banter, but not just any banter. This is relationship banter. Good banter is a hallmark of any strong bond, and Yaz and the Doctor have definitely got it. The Doctor has grumpy and irrational moments throughout this episode. The assumption is that she is worried about losing her TARDIS to the scrap planet and scavengers, but a more compelling interpretation would be that she is suppressing her own tension at having put the humans in danger, and, more specifically, she could have lost Yaz because of her carelessness. In episode 6, Demons of the Punjab, the focus shifts to Yaz's backstory and some history about her grandmother. Early in the episode, we get a moment of honest and direct intimacy between Yaz and the Doctor.
You alright?
Yaz expresses concern for the Doctor's well-being, the kind of concern you'd express for someone you really care about.
I think so. Probably. I don't know. Like I intercepted something in my brain.
And the Doctor isn't hiding her response or her own feelings from Yaz about the strange moment they just had. Multiple times, the Doctor reminds Yaz about the dangers of wandering into your own personal history.
Yaz! Be careful what you say back there. The wrong word in the wrong moment. You can interfere yourself out of existence. Do you understand?
We expect this of time travelers, and the Doctor has said something similar to many a companion about this kind of situation. It's also a moment where the Doctor tells Yaz that she is getting into higher responsibility time travel moments.
Still not interfering, are we? Oi! The alien assassin started it. We can't leave now. If something happens to Umbreen, your whole timeline could be erased.
Moments later, she gets even more serious.
No, Yaz! We can't have a universe with no Yaz!
While all these moments are played off as routine time traveler conversations, the implications are clear that the Doctor does not want a universe without Yaz. As in episode 4, when Yaz says, I want more of you, and you're the best person I know, here the Doctor is saying, a universe without Yaz scarcely bears thinking about. These lines are delivered straight, especially in this episode, but there's no denying that they hold deeper meaning for the characters speaking those words, even if the characters can't voice those deeper meanings. They are bubbling out in key moments like this. The Doctor also becomes a part of Yaz's history, the same way the Doctor became interwoven with the stories of Amy, Rory, and Riversong.
You could marry us, Euron. Thought we were not getting involved? Only a teensy bit.
When the Doctor begins to get involved in one person's history so directly, it's usually a precursor to something bigger. I also believe that the Doctor is time-sensitive to what is supposed to happen, especially when it comes to someone she is close to. And now she is doing this for Yaz because she unconsciously knows that not doing so would change events, and Yaz wouldn't become the Yaz that she knows and wants in her life.
I know there aren't many certainties in any of our lives. But Umbreen, Prem, what I see in you is the certainty you have in each other. You both found love with each other. You believed in it. You fought for it, and you waited for it. And now, you're committing to it. Which makes you, right now, the two strongest people on this planet. Maybe in this universe.
Committing to each other makes you the strongest two people in the universe. Will we see this with Yaz and the Doctor before the end of 13's run? I want to hope for a happy ending with Yaz and the Doctor, but with only two episodes remaining before the Doctor regenerates and presumably Yaz departs the TARDIS, there's not a lot of room for an extended honeymoon moment. Not even something like Riversong and the 12th Doctor got on Deryllium. No happy ending implies something less happy. And if the repeated warnings in this episode about Yaz writing herself out of existence are foreshadowing an end to 13 and Yaz, then I don't want to go. Both episodes have throwaway lines in the beginning suggesting Team TARDIS has been deep into new adventures, adventures we will never see on screen. An indeterminate amount of time has passed, but we can assume it is significant by the names of key events mentioned. The Doctor and Yaz repeatedly have pure chemistry on screen. We see this especially in the relationship quarrel. Banter is a sign of a powerful bond and a close relationship. Plus, the Doctor gets to say things out loud about Yaz's importance to her, just like Yaz got to do at the end of episode 4. Because of situational context, Yaz may not notice. Demons of the Punjab also gives us one of the most important explanations of Doctor Who lore in recent years. The details of how the TARDIS telepathic circuits actually work.
I suppose I could loop this into the TARDIS's telepathic circuits.
This thing's telepathic too?
And yes, she does have telepathic navigation, sort of. Shorthand for a very complicated process which is way beyond your understanding.
Tar very much, I only hang around here to be insulted.
Any object amasses all sorts of fragmentary spatio-temporal particles through its life. The TARDIS can read it, like date stamps. What do you two reckon?
Sometimes names are not about accuracy in the details, but they are about framing something complex in terms that someone less adroit can understand. And sometimes they are fancified just for fun. I'll see you next time as we continue to parse out relationship moments between Yaz and the 13th Doctor in the following episodes. Click the link in the corner for the next video, or find links in the description to all parts of the series.